There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least, for most of the questions of my heart, like why are we here and where do we go and knock on us so hard. It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Just might find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do, but if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between.
We're in relationships with people. It could even be a work relationship. It could be, you know, a romantic relationship or not, or a relationship with your kids or family or whoever. But a lot of times we are coming to this situation meeting other people's needs, but not expecting or voicing, not expecting ours needed, ours to be filled. Like we don't have any needs. And furthermore, not even voicing those, so people don't even have the chance. I do this. And I was hearing something earlier and I thought, wow, what ways that this plays into our group? Because a lot of times we are kind of like, I don't want to say martyrs, but we don't put ourselves first. We don't tell people how to treat us. You know what I mean? We show them that we allow them to treat us poorly. And it's enough. Enough is enough, right? And that's not selfish. It's giving. It's giving because when you can love yourself, you can love them. You know, what if you just quit doing all the things that they expect you to do? They have expectations of you in this relationship and you feel those, though they don't feel theirs. What if you quit doing those things? Would that be okay? No, that wouldn't get it. And you would hear about it, wouldn't you? Because you have taught them that you're going to show up in their life and you're going to meet their expectations. Well, on the flip side, we need to teach people that we have needs in these relationships too, right? The number one need is for them to allow you to get to yourself, right? You know, when you meet other people's needs and they do not meet yours, I jotted down some notes on this. You know, they expect X, okay? Maybe it's a dating relationship and this man or this partner expects you to show up and look like dynamite, you know? They expect you to have on the heels and the short skirt and they don't even show up like that. They've got on like their gym shirt, okay? They expect you to fulfill all these fantasies they have, okay? They expect you to show up in all those ways. And it's not that you can't be okay with that, but are they showing up in the ways you need in your life? Do you expect to have a partner that offers you security, love, you know, a nurturing relationship beyond just this superficial type thing they've got going on in their mind? Because if you're willing to meet their needs and they can come over and meet yours, you might have a common playing ground to work with. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of times people are so self-focused on what they want, they don't even understand. And a lot of these people that are playing into the life, it's almost like a narcissist attitude. Do you know what I mean? Like they expect you to meet all their needs, but they expect as long as they're there and they show up as I'm giving you me, then that's enough. And is it really? Because you've been accepting that, I've been accepting that. Is it really okay? It's like if you're to say, you know, I like when we do all these things, but you know, I would really like to talk about you know, here's some things like that concern me, or here's some things like this might not line up. And they might say, well, hey, I'm a gamble. Or they might say, oh, Tanya, don't worry about that. Or, oh, stop witching at me, or whatever. The point is this, right there, they just told you they were unwilling to compromise at all to meet any of your needs or even discuss them. Do you have people like this in your life? A lot of times these people are bringing you down. They're the demise of you. But it's not their fault. It's our fault. It's my fault and your fault, right? For not expecting people, not having needs, not even knowing what our needs are, not knowing what you want. What is your why in this relationship, right? What's your why? Anyway, I thought that was interesting. You know, they show up like you're willing to meet their needs. You know, that they want you to meet X amount of needs for them, okay? And then they just expect to just show up, right? And you want these set of needs, and you're concerned about. You know, the thing is, I'll meet none of your needs, is what they're saying, but I expect you to meet all of mine. This is not just for the dating realm. This is almost with every relationship we have. It's just like when this is a common thing. I think it was Jennifer showing us, or it was Leanne showing us her kids didn't do their part. Okay, well, what are the needs you expect me to fulfill? I'm doing those. You're falling short on your end of the bargain. These are the things I need from you, okay? And if we aren't on a common ground, we need to reevaluate because this ain't working for me. That's about where I am in my life, and it's a beautiful thing because it's not a selfish situation. It's not stingy. It's not hatred. It's none of that. It's loving me so I can love others, you know? When people shove your needs aside, you know, that they want all their needs and demands met, but they meet none of yours. They shove that to the side. You know, they're evasive. They laugh it off. Oh, you know, whatever. And then you're standing there thinking, okay, well, we didn't discuss that. I'm still in the same boat, right? They may even agree to change, but they don't do it, okay? My daughter's boyfriend does this. He agrees to do all these things, and then he just doesn't do it. And he's like, why every day are you, you know, witching at me? And she's like, well, I'm not thinking these things are too much to ask. You know, these are like basic things. But he certainly wants all his needs met. And he says, well, I came home, didn't I? Let me tell you something, buddy. Showing up, it ain't enough. Just showing your face. Do you have people like this in your life? Don't you find that interesting? I mean, maybe it is a shallow relationship. Maybe it is, but if both sides agree to that and that's what you're bringing to the table, then that's fine too. It's not even about evaluating a relationship as being right or wrong or what should the stats be on it. It's that, are you in agreeing and are you both meeting each other's person's needs? You know what I mean?